Absolutely fantastic to have you and the rest of the Loving Vincent team here tonight. What does it mean for you to have such a unique piece of art validated by all this awards, nomination, recognition?
It means we can do it all again. So we're going to do the next one's going to be a horror film based upon the paintings of Goya. And the fact that over 5 million people went to see this worldwide, and then we got, you know, the BAFTA, the Golden Globe, the Oscar nominations, just validates us and allows us to know that we weren't crazy and we can probably do it all again.
I mean, it's rare to see a piece of cinema that genuinely offers audiences something completely original and new. Can you talk about how proud you are to have tackled something so ambitious and so revolutionary?
Well, you know, I'm very proud of my wife, Dorota, because she's the main creator and came up with the idea 10 years ago in an attic in central Poland, and who thought that it would lead us here? And so, yeah, it was just an incredible sense of achievement to paint 65,000 paintings and for people to respond to the thriller story and to really like the story. So, and actually, you know, that in this category, there's never been a British film that's won. So if we win tonight, it'll be the first in history. So.
Can you talk about that moment of inspiration?
The moment of inspiration happened 10 years ago. And I was just, I really wanted to, I'm a painter myself, and I really wanted to bring the combined painting with the passion of painting and filmmaking. So I was just sitting there at the attic in Łódź and thinking about how to do it. And then I thought, this is so exciting to actually make the paintings move in front of your eyes, and that was and tell the story of an artist through the paintings.
Obviously, you have your next project in mind. What are you most excited about getting to explore that very iconic artist as well?
I'm very excited about the fact that we gain so much experience, that we know how to approach this. That means we don't have to do so many tests, so many rehearsals, and then we have this network of these beautiful artists, so it's really exciting to get them back together. And also, you know, we want to actually make this more challenging. We want to make much more freehand animation, and yeah, it's going to be fun.
It's going to be another mystery because, you know, Goya, when he was 43, had this illness and had all of these visions, and then went deaf and lived another 40 years, and no one really knows what happened to him in those months, and that's one of the things we want to find out. And obviously he has these incredible demonic and series of paintings, the dark paintings he did late in life, which are very intriguing, and I think they'll make a great story.
What do you think is so unique and special about animation in terms of what it gives storytellers and an audience?
Well, I mean, I think that you need to find the right approach to each story. And with this one, there was only one way to really do it, because, you know, it was all about Vincent's story. And Vincent's story is so tied up with his paintings that the best way we could tell his story was by bringing his paintings to life. And so, yeah, it's like watching a moving Van Gogh in front of your eyes for 90 minutes.